Hello to the two fans and welcome. This is Chicago Ted coming to you with another replay cast. This one is going to be an ID that I do not have open or available to me right now, so I can't really read it out. But whatever the ID is, it's in the title. Thank you to the donator for this game, and I hope you enjoy. So let's get a move on here, trying to keep the spoilers. I gotta do this fast. Boom. All right, here we go. And free camera up, ready to go. All right, so for the Dire team this time around, it's going to be Yoda playing the Wind Ranger. Rowls is going to be on the Phantom Assassin with Davy Gravy on the Venomancer. Dota 2 Customer Service is going to be playing the Doombringer, and Red is going to be on the Tidehunter. And, you know, so far this team looking pretty cancer, I'm not going to lie. But an equally annoying team to go up against is going to be a name I cannot read playing the Shadow Demon. Promise is Shit going to be on the Ursa with another name I can't read on the Rubik. Mad Maniac is going to be playing the Batrider. And finally, Muku on the Chaos Knight. God, I love and hate this hero at the same time. Loved playing him until he became broken, and now I just feel bad every single time.
And here we go.
Dire looking to contest the top rune. They should get it. Radiant, meanwhile, going for the cliff on Red, but won't get it off. The Rubik close. I'm not sure you can actually cliff on this one, but it's worth a try. It looks like he just kind of went for the telekinesis and then did nothing afterwards. Whatever the case, it is going to be a lack of first blood or any real engagements happening for the first couple of moments of the game. And we will devolve into our lanes as it's going to be the Wind Ranger versus Shadow Demon in the mid. Yoda shouldn't have too hard of a time here. Shadow Demon not exactly being a more meta mid pick. And likewise, Wind Ranger is just incredibly powerful at both melee and ranged matchups. It really is tough to beat her. Meanwhile, Rawl's going to have a bit of trouble on the top as Muku is chasing her down. They've got the Napalm sticking her to the ground. They're just going to dive underneath the Tier 1 tower, and there's not a lot that she can do, actually, except blink away as Davy Gravy giving her that option. Now Mad Maniac is going to go down to the tower here. In fact, Davy Gravy actually going to grab the last hit, Muku. Meanwhile, not enough mana for another Chaos Bolt. He's not going to turn and fight instead, looking to run away, but Rawls, he doesn't actually have the dagger. He can't stifle him up and slow him down. Instead, Muku will get away, popping the salve, which will get canceled by a stray right-click from a creep. But in the end, getting himself out of there alive, kind of interesting. At the same time, though, that was a very necessary skill for Rawls to get, having the blink able to get away from a very sticky situation, quite literally sticky situation that he was in underneath his own Tier 1. A heads-up play from Davy Gravy to give him that option of escaping right there. So this dual lane up top will prove to be a little bit more than the Dire we're bargaining for, but it seems like Rawls has Rawls and Davy Gravy have their grasp on the situation. Speaking of grasp, Red is going to have a decent time on the bottom, has already gotten level 3, and is seeming to have a fairly okay CS score. Four last hits, better than most offlaners can hope for, and he doesn't have any support. In fact, he's actually got the counter, which is Rubik, the counter support, trying to force him back and zone him out, but Rubik, not the best starting damage, and the Kraken Shell is going to help Red just kind of shrug off most of these attacks. You can see Promise's Shit doing very little damage initially, though that does stack up with the Fury Swipes. It still starts out as not quite a lot. And Yoda, he's actually looking like he's out of mana. It seems like he's been spamming his Power Shot, which hasn't exactly worked out for him, but in the end, he's doing all right. Decent CS. Mad Maniac on the top. Could be going down here, but looks like Rawls wasn't quite able to get the Stifling Dagger. Still on cooldown. No Blink Strike, though. He could end up diving this one. Mad Maniac's going to walk right back in, but he's not in position for it. Meanwhile, Red on the bottom is going to go down. Promises Shit. It is actually going to be the Rubik to bring down Red with what seems to be either his right or the right click or the fade bolt. Whatever the case, Promise's Shit probably did most of the heavy lifting there. And I mean, we talked about him being naturally tanky, Red being able to survive against that lane, but sometimes if you're out of position, a slow and a stun is all it takes to bring you down. Speaking of, a slow is Rawls to take down Mad Maniac on the top, though. He's in a bit of trouble from the tower right clicks. He's going to survive through it. Only has some tangos, the shared tango from Davy Gravy, to keep himself rather healthy. Red, though, is once again in a tough situation. However, there is no telekinesis up for Rubick. He already used it, and now he's out of mana, cannot use it again. So it seems like Promise is shit. He's going to back himself away and go right back to farming up. He's got the phase boots at the ready. Personal favorite of mine would be the treads, but that's just me. I'm kind of a strange player when it comes to Ursa. There's going to be the Venomous Gale out on a Mad Maniac. They get him with the Shadow Strike 2 or the Stifling Dagger. Now they're just going to chase him down. The two slows becoming a massive problem. However, on that same note, Red's going to go down in the bottom lane with Muku coming in for the gank. That is a Chaos Knight deciding that the top lane just isn't quite his cup of tea. Instead, wants to come down bottom to grab some stray kills and maybe even farm up the jungle. It's not quite something that the Chaos Knight is known for doing, but hell, if he wants to go ahead and gank other lanes, more power to him, as it looks like he's tailgating Mr. Rubick. They give the regen to him, though. I would imagine the Rubick would be the better shot with multiple telekinesis and fade bolts, but it's going to be the disruption now. Out on a Yoda, maybe a bit early. They get him with the purge. And Muku comes in, going out with a Chaos Bolt. The purge will secure the last bit of damage. That's one thing that a Windranger is not expecting at 4.5 to 5 minutes, is a Chaos Knight ganking her lane. But now, Dota 2 Customer Service is in a lot of trouble. They've got the Clarity, they got the Reality Rift, they'll pull him right back in. Chaos Knight just gonna go ahead and right-click him down. Needs one more, or maybe one more, as a huge damage spread. Now he needs one more. That'll be the kill for Muku. Finding a couple, actually. Well, okay, he didn't actually get the one in the mid lane, but it was close. Meanwhile, Mad Maniac will go ahead and bring down Davy Gravy as Red is finding Muku in the jungle, but this is not a level 6 Tidehunter. In fact, he's only got his level 4, and does not really have any damage. Mad Maniac will go down to Rawls in the top lane, but that'll be the end of most of the kills going down. And just to recap, this isn't actually the good recap, but a massive gank coming out from Muku. I guess Rubick was a little bit useful in that one, but it mostly was Muku going in, finding a kill in the bottom lane, then rotating up through the mid and then into the jungle, finding a grand total of 3 kills with their contributions. Just active across the map is what they gotta be, and they're doing just that. Yoda, meanwhile, he had gone down once to Shadow Demon, and I mean, no, he does actually have Demonic Purge. Doesn't seem like he's gonna pop it out just yet, as the gank's coming in. Looks like from Dota 2 player, or what is it? Dota 2 community, or customer service, rather. There is a Demonic Prayer down to Yoda. That's going to be enough damage. Maybe, yeah, with a shout-out to Boyzen coming through. And it looks like he will end up going down himself to Dota 2 customer service. It's an okay trade, a mid for a mid. Only one mid actually getting the kill on the other, though. And I mean, you never really want to give the kill to a Doombringer. Especially not this early as far as the mid player goes, but for the most part, you know, it's not entirely terrible to take that trade. And it looks like maybe they can stop customer service a little bit by going in for this gank. It doesn't seem like, okay, actually, no, he had a good idea. They were coming through with this Observer Ward that is going down. But now customer service will make his way through to the top lane. An Observer Ward will spot the fact that he's not available on the map anymore, but it doesn't even matter as he comes through, gets the Doom off. The Pentagram gonna burn Mad Maniac down. It looks like it might barely be enough damage. It's gonna take him away. Needs only 4 more ticks, but he's only gonna get 3. Yeah, only got 3 more. So, and in fact, he regened up that last tick anyway, so he would not have gone down, but rather unfortunate. A Doom spent a costly gank, and they're not able to secure the kill. But now, Rubick has made his way up top. Muku's there as well. They're just going to be aggressive up close and personal. Meanwhile, Yoda throwing down some hate on the mid-tier 1 tower. He's got the focus fire, but that won't last all that much longer. And going for the creep kill. Could have been a boots of travel, but it wasn't actually, as oh no, Rubick and Muku come up. They're gonna find the courier, but that's about it. Do they actually get it? No, they've got no way, no damage really to deal to the courier. Only one Rubick right click, and the courier, he's got 10 armor, 150 HP, but oh boy, that's actually an interesting kill. Promises shit. Well, TP, yeah, it looks like he popped into his ultimate to avoid any real tick to bring him down. Now Yoda in a lot of trouble. They've got the lasso out, and that'll last through the wind run. And so Yoda will go down. Mad Maniac this time getting killed, but Mooku wasn't close. Gets the experience, gets some gold. Is all right with that one. Red has meanwhile gone to the ancients to pick up a small stack. It looks like only two big ancient camps there, as usually if there was a third, well, that creep would be alive then too. So not going to be enough to skyrocket him towards that blink dagger, but definitely getting him some much needed gold after what seems like it turned into a pretty bad lane for him.
Guess what's happening to Dire's bottom
tower. Rawls going toe-to-toe with Mad Maniac. Looks like Yoda's coming in for the gank, but Mad Maniac is far back. They've got no creeps to solicit the attack. And meanwhile, Promises Shit will make his way to the Roche Pit. Mooku's there up on the high ground. Shadow Demon's there as well, providing some support in the actual pit itself. But he's not really making that big of an impact. It's more moral support than anything, but Promises Shit will go ahead and grab that Aegis Immortality. 9.5 minutes is the game time for that one. So the next Roshan we expect is going to be back up within 8 to 13. So we'll keep an eye on that. Figure what the time, 8 to 11 maybe? No. God, I'm blanking so hard on that right now. Whatever the case, he's going to be back in some amount of time. And for right now, the Urs is going to have a second life to play around with, and play around he shall. Already proving to be a little bit more aggressive on the bottom lane, though. I think his priority right now has to be farming. He did end up opting for the Vladimir's Offering. This is a very outdated build, in my opinion. The Vladimir's as well as the Phase Boots, proving to be something that, you know, by and large are not items that Ursa really needs, but we'll have to see if he's going to be able to make use of it. As he's going in on Yoda, ends up turning around, he wants Davy Gravy. It's the easier of the two kills, arguably, and we'll just need one more right click to go for this one. Yoda going to walk himself away. Mooku does not have a Chaos Bolt out of mana. Rawls will TP into this one, though. But now Rubick is in a lot of trouble. He's going to Blink Strike forward. They're going to do a lot of damage to Rubick, but the Demonic Purge comes out. Promises Shit missing every other auto attack. They get the Chaos Bolt. They get the Purge through. The Rupture, Ravage will fly. That's not going to save Rawls' life. Red now getting blown to bits by Promises Shit, and Yoda on the run too. Yoda should go down. Promises Shit actually does not have any slows to bring him down, at least not a Orb of Venom. Did have his Earth Shock, but that was out of mana, so I think I was going back to a initial statement, though. Actually, no, maybe not. As Batrider, Madman is going to be able to bring down Dota 2 Customer Service. Other way around. Dota 2 Customer Service gets Mad Maniac. Oh, that's big. Rubick will steal the Doom. Not going to be able to get it off on the Doom himself. But that next target better be careful. And I imagine they know that that Doom is the other way. Oh boy, that's trouble. You never really want to give up that Doom in any scenario, but it could make a huge difference in these next coming fights. You drop a Doom on, say, Yoda, and he's not getting away alive. In fact, it looks like that might be the plan. Didn't want to spend the Demonic Purge, though. It looks like they could have, but will not go for it. Anyway, I was talking about the Ursa's build, and I think I'll touch upon it briefly now, but the phase in the Vladimir's, first of all, he doesn't need the Vladimir's because the Furious Wipes is not a unique attack modifier, and still some Ursa's will end up going for it because it opens up the option to go for something like a Diffusal Blade or a Desolator at some point in the game. And both of those items proving to be okay, but in my opinion, or at least in the way I typically see and play Ursa, it ends up being you go for just the Morbid Mask until you decide what you want to do, whether you want to go straight in for the Satanic and end up going huge on the Lifesteal, or go for the other unique attack modifiers and then build into a Vlad. But looks like the Shackle's out on the Shadow Demon. Mooku will turn around for the Chaos Bolt on Davy Gravy. Yoda's still alive and kicking, though. They don't have the Doom anymore. It looks like they took it away, didn't end up spending it. I don't know. Either way, Dota 2 Customer Service, it seemed like he threw the Doom, but it didn't connect onto anything but maybe a creep. I didn't even see it. Meanwhile, Promises Shit going to chase down, looking for Davy Gravy. He does have the Aegis of Immortality. Meanwhile, on the back lines, Rawls will clean up Mad Maniac. And now we'll look to Promises Shit, who's still in through this one. This is a way disastrous fight for the Radiant side as they lose three. and will not get anything out of this one. We can take a look at the recap. And actually, okay, they do get something. They get a buyback off the Doom. Didn't even notice that happened, but in the end, it's about a 1,000 gold swing, and now they'll go for more. They want Rubick. They got him. Get a little bit of vision. Got the Shadow Strike off, Slifeling Dagger. Shadow Strike is a dagger, but it's on the Queen of Pain. Completely different hero, not even in this game. Mad Maniac gonna go straight on in. They're gonna go out with the Red gonna come in with the Ravage. They pull down Mad Maniac. They should be able to bring him down. They'll turn around for Muku, as Phantasm is the skill I was looking for. Jesus. Sometimes I really hate myself. Anyway, Shadow Demon will turn around, bring down Yoda. So it ends up being a trade at most. They'll get the Bat Raider. They also got the Rubick at some point and way before that fight. And the only cost is a Doom buyback and a Wind Ranger. So, but what I meant to say at the start of the fight was Phantasm with an unlucky roll. He only got one extra Phantasm unit, which is 2x the damage. It's respectable, but certainly not where you want to be for such a clutch fight that you want to be able to take. An interesting build for this Chaos Knight, mind you. It was an offlane Chaos Knight, so it wasn't a farming role. He ends up opting for the Soul Ring because of that, being able to get all of his spells off. We saw he ganked off and not going for a point in his crit. Chaos Strike to be more formal. Mostly because he's not really worrying about being that right-clicker yet. He knows he's got an Ursa to fill in that role. So he just needs to play the rotate, gank, set up kills, maybe get one or two of them, but along that line of reasoning, the Phantasm probably wasn't the correct skill there. Maybe get an extra point in the Chaos Bowl, just because Phantasm's a lot of mana. Rawls will get brought down by Mad Maniac, meanwhile on the top lane, Dota 2 customer service. They'll throw out a Doom onto the Rubick. He ends up taking a lot of damage from the Demonic Purge, but he should be able to live through. Oh, wait, no, his Scorched Earth went down. Rubick will steal Scorched Earth some way throughout that fight. It seemed like he was doomed for a while, but maybe that was late. Whatever the case, it'll get denied, so he won't actually be able to use it at any point. Still, Doom, Dota 2 customer service will not get the kill, and that is the most important part about that exchange. So Rawls going down somewhere else along that fight. Doom will be down for a buyback duration death. And Rubick, the only collateral, getting denied, so not giving anything the other way. As far as net worth goes, we're looking at an Ursa who is near the top, but surprisingly enough, Shadow Demon's at the top. He's got 6 kills, which explains a lot of that. Only 50 CS at 16 minutes. Not that respectable. I mean, okay, it's fine considering looking at the overall CS. He is towards the top, but I think the important part is that Yoda, his opponent in lane, is doing a little worse than that, as he only had about 47, and okay, promises shit. Ends up breaking down Red in the bottom lane. That's an interesting kill to say the least, but I think that was a Blink Dagger reveal that I should have been watching, mind you, but eh. Sometimes shit happens. That Blink Dagger, though, we're going to be pretty huge. That is an item that I do like to see, and Rawl is getting pulled out by a Lasso. Past the tier 1 tower. The Lasso doesn't last all that long, but they had plenty of time to get the kills that they need. Mad Maniac will end up getting it as he's sitting in the flame from the Firefly. And Dota 2 customer service looking for the Doom, but it's going to be the Phantasm out from Mook, who turns around. 1 second stun, that's all he needs. These illusions are dealing a lot of damage. However, he'll come back with a Ravage coming out from Red. The Doom out onto Mad Maniac to go for the disruption to save Muku's life, at least for the time being. A Demonic Purge now out onto Dota 2 customer service, but he will be brought down by the Chaos Bolt. Meanwhile, Red getting torn to bits by Promises Shit. Now, Davey Gravy will be on the run, but Shadow Demon is going to bring him down with just some poison. And it'll be a 1-4-4. And 17 minutes, 14 kills on the side of the Dire. It's going to be Yoda trying to make the most of this one, as he's able to bring down a bottom tier 1 tower, but at most it's going to be a trade, as a top tier 1 will also fall, making it 1 tier 1 down on the Radiant side. The Dire, though, have lost 2. And we can already tell that they're starting to pull behind as far as overall game goes. I mean, okay, Yoda is at the top of the net worth. Or, sorry, that's current gold. He's not the top of the net worth. He's far from the top of the net worth. Okay, top 4. But as far as the graphs go, Yeah, Radiant's got about a 4K lead in the gold department. Experience, 5K and just shy of, rather. So you can tell they've got some extra levels. We can actually take a look at what those extra levels are. I think it's T. No, that's buyback status. Oh, God. Hero level is E for me. For some reason, I'm not sure. Whatever the case, you can see the top three levels are all belonging to the Radiant side, though level 11 is tied by two of the Dire. It's just a problem when you just don't have anyone that is on par with their highest level. You want to try to get some split farming going, go for the experience, and maybe try to win off the back of adding spells at a decent level, but... Pan Mania gonna blink forward and pull back Red. Promises Shit gonna blink on in. They go for the lasso, but it's not gonna latch onto anything but himself, though. They turn around for the Doom. Promises Shit taking a bit of damage now, even more that his enrage is off, and he'll get brought down. One swipe of the sword, or whatever that is, for Rawls will bring him down. Now they'll turn and look to chase for more. They'll get the Stifling Dagger out onto the Shadow Demon, but the Force Staff will bring him up into a safe spot. Meanwhile, Rubick will get level dead, but look at the damage coming out! Rawls comes forward and is able to swipe him down. Oh boy, that is a much-needed kill for this Phantom Assassin. That puts him up pretty high on the net worth, actually, only trailing by about 700 from the Ursa. A little bit more. Actually, he's going to go ahead for another kill on the Mad Maniac. They should have another slow from Davy Gravy, which will keep him within right-clicking distance. Only needs one more swipe, but Yoda's going to be happy to take that one. Rawls, meanwhile, taking a bit of damage. They've got the Demonic Purge. It should not be enough to kill. He just has to not chase anymore. So 225 is the total sum of damage that comes out that way. Only about half of his remaining HP pool, but
Radiant's mid towers
still kept him from being any more aggressive. And that kill, I mean, he didn't get the kill on the Batrider. That would have been great if he had gotten it, but oh, hold on. He hit lane once again. Doom the Gravy. Gonna be in a bit of trouble. There's a Dagon coming out. Who is that from? It looked like it was from Shadow Demon, and it is. Shadow Demon picking up a Dagon. Oh, God. I'm known to hate Dagon pickups, but I may regret saying this later. I kind of like it right now. Shadow Demon. Okay, I like it and hate it. I like it because it'll go with his Demonic Purge, as well as the Soul Catcher. It'll deal a massive amount of damage, and it should mean he'll be able to pick up any kill across the map. I dislike it because of the gold investment that he's going to need to make to keep that sustained. Actually, disruption out onto Rawls. Should be the death of him. Does he have anyone to jump to? Ends up turning around. Whatever. He had no allies in the vicinity to help him out. But I do not like the gold investment that it puts on him, because we look 10... If he ever stops farming, or if the kills stop coming his way, and he still goes for that Dagon, first of all, it's not going to scale very well. He's got to keep upgrading it once he buys it. Unless he wants to be sitting with a pretty useless 400 damage nuke. Okay, it's respectable, but it doesn't scale well. Oh, okay, hold that thought as Mooku will get lashed to a creep. They'll throw out a Demonic Purge on the Yoda, though, and that won't be enough to lock him in place for a kill. So back to that statement. So if he ends up going for a different item, then that kind of reduces the utilization that Dagon's going to end up having. Meanwhile, we're looking at the fact that his farming speed is going to be slowed down, so he can't continue going for the Dagon without getting kills. And I don't know, circular reasoning here. The main gist of what I'm saying is he needs to keep getting kills if he's going to go Dagon. And right now, it doesn't seem like this mid-engagement is being too fruitful for him. And his farming speed, well, that leaves a lot to be desired. Sure, he's going to go down and bring down some creeps, but... he's got to focus on farming pretty heavily if he wants to keep that sustained. Meanwhile, though, Mooku has picked up a Sanj, so is it going to be going for any sort of armlet, Satanics, or... okay, Satanic is a little bit down the road, but armlets or Helm of the Dominators, yet instead wants to go straight in for that, what I imagine would be a Sanj and Yasha, or just straight Heaven's Halberd, which will stop Rawls and will protect himself from Rawls, and ultimately... will keep Rawls down as best as possible. That's all you can hope for right now. You do not want to give that one fight that Chef Phantom Assassin needs, because you give her a wipe, or you give her an ultra or a triple kill even, she'll come out with a Satanic full item set, and it will be impossible to win that next fight. Promise of shit. Meanwhile, the Doom is out onto the Ursa. Fearless Web still latching, but it's going to be the lasso coming out onto Davy Gravy. Will get canceled immediately by the Ravage, as now Mooku comes in. And was there a Venomancer there? I do not think so. Well, he was able to get his Poison Nova off, though, which is pretty huge. Meanwhile, Promise of Shit getting latched to Shadow Demon. Red will not survive this one as the Demonic Courage comes through. Well, looking for another Shadow Strike, or sorry, a Blink Strike will come out onto Yoda. Actually, it looks like it was onto the Rubik. Get some chase damage off, but Promise of Shit will now look for Yoda as he comes in with his Overpower. Thrall's now stuck in the trees. He's got to turn and fight onto the Shadow Demon, but he's fighting into a majority of heroes, and it looks like he'll just be brought down underneath his own Tier 1 tower as his team is all back, either in the fountain or dead. Not a great fight right now for the Dire, as they constantly are just getting played around with. Okay, not constantly. They've had some really good fights, but they've also had some really disastrous fights, that being one of them. So we'll sit at 18 kills to the 27 of the Radiant. Two-thirds of their kills, actually, which I guess is better than what it could be, but for all intents and purposes, there is a lot of growing room that they need to fill. Technical difficulties. So Mad Maniac, we'll just make a casual push down the mid lane. Can't really be pushing alone, but the ward not prioritizing the right target first will mean that Mad Maniac can blink away, react to the situation at hand. Dota 2 customer service has gone for the phase blink build, so a lot of mobility, but not a lot of tank, at least not yet. He's naturally tanky, but only 6 armor to go with that is going to mean he gets blown up pretty quickly. Now a lasso should pull him onto the low ground. Maybe just barely doesn't. Yeah, he'll survive just because of that. If this Batrider had a 4-staff ready, that would have been a sure kill, but going in right before the 4-staff. In fact, he's got it. He just needs to deliver it on the courier. A little bit of mistiming going on there will result in what could have been a kill now lost. And Dire will go right back to farming. But at the very least, the Shadow Demon is filling that quota for the Dagon. Has only finished actually a level 2 Dagon. Now going for what looks like an Ethereal Blade. Interesting mover there. Could be very good against Rawls. We've discussed as customer service getting blown to bits by Promise's shit. And now Red on the run. But the slows are there. They'll push him into the trees. A little bit of misplaced in the flame break. Mad Maniac will now 4-staff forward, but now with no escape, he's going to be brought down, or at least chased out. There's a Ravage coming out from Red. They'll also come out with the Poison Nova. Promise his shit will blink on forward, but he's going to have to be careful of the amount of damage coming out from this one. Rawls, meanwhile, is waiting for his moment to strike, but that is a Heaven's Halberd completed, which means Rawls cannot just jump in and expect a kill. Maybe he goes for it anyway. Oh, the illusions are going to prove to be a little bit more than he can handle right now. He's going to bring him down with his Battle Fury, but it's just a whole lot of what do you do? They're so tanky, and they've got a lot of spells to just say, hey, you want to engage into us? Well, we'll make your life a living hell. So I'm pretty sure Shadow Demon is actually a living hell. Promise his shit, maybe a little less, but still with the BKB and the Blink Dagger, there's no running away from this bear. He will run up straight on into you and just try to bring you down. Oh boy, customer service trying to get in his head. Kind of play the mind games. I'm not quite sure if that's going to work right now. It's 28-18, about 27 minutes into this game. And things are not looking too great for the Dire squad. Vito, it's your customer service. He's going to go straight on in, be the big bad Doom. Now gets lasso pulled in. Customer service. I can't tell if that was a tactical maneuver or a straight feed, but in the end, the result is the same. He is down. And the Dire struggling to look for a way to even try to engage in. They'll TP back at least Davy Gravy. And Rawls will also make his way back into the fray. But there's a tier 3 that's being knocked down by a whole bunch of CK illusions. Yoda will find the lasso on the Mad Maniac. They're able to get some sort of kill out of this one. Though, Radiant's going to have to back off. They still get a whole lot of damage on that tier 3 tower. Maybe one more good fight like they've taken, and they should be able to bring down Arrax. So meanwhile, the Radiant will go right back to farming. The Aegis is down on the Ursa. It'll be back up in about a minute and change, depending on what the randomized timer ends up coming out to. We're also getting dangerously close to his level 16. Only needs two or three more creeps before he's able to grab that one. Snag it for some extra crit damage. But they've got to keep an eye on this Roche pit. They cannot let Ursa just get a free Roche on. I mean, it is going to be a cheese this next time. So if they give up another Aegis and a cheese, they could very well be facing a loss. But if they're able to contest it, which, you know, it would be hard. But if you go in with a perfect Ravage and then Rawls comes in and cleaves people down with the Battle Fury that he's got, then perhaps they can take a fight in the pit. Then they can grab the Aegis and the cheese, and boy, that would be a turning point to sing about in ages to come. But I'm not quite sure Radiant are looking to give that one up. I mean, such is a turn that they probably wouldn't even need to worry about if Mad Maniac just positions himself correctly, is able to get the Firefly off to grab vision around the pit, then they should not see any surprises. And an easy Roshan, given they all commit to it, should be on the menu for them in the next minute or so. But Yoda will position himself around the pit. Could check it every now and then, but result is that the Roche will not be up for another 30 or so seconds. So a rotation will come around from the Radiant. Windranger has already backed himself away. Yoda, sensing blood in the water, has to get himself out of there before he goes down. And with 35 seconds in the pit, the Dire need be very careful about this one. Get themselves close. Don't let any freebies happen. At least, you know, try to make this difficult for them. But the Radiant will be active about this. They go in for the bottom tier 2 tower. This tower will secure once and for all this Roche pit for them, as they can get vision up around the pit. No access points for the Dire. If they start to go south, they can't just buy back and TP in close. But the Radiant will get that tier 1, or get that tier 2. Roshan will spawn almost like clockwork. And now all it takes is the Dire to scout it out. And they should be able to grab this one quickly. They'll do so. Promises Shit and Miku in the pit. The Dire within proximity to this one, but it doesn't seem like they've made any maneuvers to try to contest it. Yep. Free Roshan. Miku should be able to grab the cheese. Promises Shit with the Aegis Immortality. I wonder who. Yeah, it will be Miku to get the cheese. And this next fight is going to be very difficult for the Dire to take. They almost have to just wait out the Aegis and Cheese just to survive. So imagine, get up onto the high ground, make life difficult, try to delay as long as possible. And once that Aegis and Cheese goes down, maybe you'd have a shot. But that window is closing, as the Ursa is going to be able to grab a Monkey King Bart very soon. Miku gonna have his true strike. I imagine not close, but close enough. He has gone for the evasion. Looks like a Mantis style coming out from him, but I don't know. I think I'd like to see the MKB come out a little more, as, yep, still trying to get in his head. Dota 2 customer service being a little bit of an annoyance here, as Promise Shit will now go up onto the high ground onto Dota 2, who will be forced out away to safety. The lasso now out as they pull in to break the lasso. Actually, Yoda will survive because of this. They come out with the Poison Nova. Yoda now on the run. There is going to be the what looks to be the Demonic Purge out into him, but that's not going to mean all that much. No, it was just a Soul Catcher. As now Rawls will bring down Mad Maniac. Oh boy, there's got to be a lot of hate coming out here. It wasn't the Forest Staff. It was the pull away from the Chaos Knight. Now the Aegis will get triggered. Promise Shit will go out for the PKB, promptly timed, as the Ravage isn't going to catch him, but Promise Shit just getting kited. Red is caught within his crosshairs, though. Still slowed down. Red is actually able to walk away. Promise is going to turn around, but there's a Ravage stolen by Rubik. And customer service will go down. Rawls will go as well. A 2-for-2 trade, two cores from kind of two supports. As now Yoda on the run, Miku will try to chase him down. Davy Gravy will go up out of the high ground. There's going to be an eating of the cheese, as Yoda's still trying to run away, but it's getting canceled. The Reality Rift He can't find the vision. Promise this shit will come up into the high ground, though. A 2-second stun Chaos Bolt will bring down Yoda, and Red is on the run, but Red is most likely dead. They just need one more rift, and they got it. This should be Arax here. But Yoda will buy back into the game, and now Promise's shit's got to be careful. All Yoda has to do is TP right about here, and I imagine Promise is dead. But instead, he'll power shot forward, but Promise will blink away. And what could have been Arax turns into not Arax, turns into all of Radiant just backing out. But let that be a lesson to Batriders, or to Chaos Knights, rather, when you've got a Batrider in your team. Don't rift the guy being lassoed, because that will break the lasso. Distance breaks lasso, and it's and also if you move too far, I think it also breaks the lasso. Whatever the case, I know it was probably was a rift that broke. Either way, they're gonna turn out Doom onto Mooku. They get the Heaven's Halberd on the Rawls, but that doesn't really mean all that much. Mooku's just dead. Dota 2 customer service will get the kill from the Doom Tick, but that was a group effort, really. And, oh boy, that's just not a kill you want to be giving up. You don't want to be giving up any kills right now. You, by and large, just won the game-winning team fight in their base, exposing or could be exposing their racks, and you get nothing out of it? Now Yoda will go forward, goes out for the lasso, or the shackle out onto the Shadow Demon. Isn't able to latch him, but it's not about latching, it's about sending a message. Yoda will go in to the Windrun up onto the high ground. Now Rawls goes out for a BKB, promises shit now. Gonna turn around looking for anyone he can get, but is not able to find a kill anywhere. Red will get brought down to the Ravage. Now the Poison Nova out. That's gonna deal a decent amount of damage to Mad Maniac, Rubick, and Shadow Demon, all caught by it. Rawls will come forward, Mad Maniac brought down. Dota 2 customer service will go out onto Rubick, who stole another Ravage. This one, though, is going to be inconsequential, as they'll find 4-for-2. Dota 2 customer service getting the all-2 game-throwing killing spree, as he'll grab a Heaven's Halberd of his own. Meanwhile, Phantom Assassin looking for that Basher. Not even going for the MKB yet. Speaking of not going for the MKB, it is going to be Mooku going for the Manta style. Oh boy. So yeah, the general gist of that last fight is, oh god, our Radiant throwing. It's it comes down to, I don't know. I still think they could have done a significant amount more collateral damage in the mid lane, but where they took that fight was kind of the problem there. And I imagine the same result would have come about if they had just stopped at the tower and gone for objective gaming, maybe rotated down to bring down this tier 2. But they instead dove right back behind the tower. Oh, I can draw on the map, but I can't draw on the ground. Okay, look at the mini-map. They dove right back the tower, and they took the fight where if they drop low, they can't just rotate around and push, because then they buy back, or then Dire buys back and just bull rushes into them and gets a team wipe. So what they gotta do is not just go straight in, but instead go to about where the tower is and play objective gaming. Hit the tower. If they come into engage to you, you win the fight still. If they don't, you get the tower, maybe even the Rax. Or they could just rotate, get the tower, and then get another tier 3 tower. And that exposes Rax. So that makes it easier to split push. That makes it a lot easier to take consequent fights. Or consecutive fights, rather. Because then, if Dire steps 1 foot out of line, they lose a Rax. If they step 2 feet out of line, they lose 2 Rax. And so the progression goes. But now Dire or Radiant are playing a game where, yes, all 3 towers are still up. They will still be able to have the same effect if they bring down another team fight. But the only difference is now they can't just naturally push in a lane and have the Dire have to respond. Like, see what they're doing here? If there was no tier 3 up, then this wave would just push in past it, and then it'll get to the Rax, and then the equilibrium will stay at this Rax because there are no towers to push it the other way. So the next wave comes in, the wave that exists, the Dire wave that exists, is weakened enough that the next wave will bring them down and then go in for the Rax again, and the story will keep going and going and going until the Rax are either dead or the Dire respond to it. And that response is what you want to elicit because, or solicit, because then you push another wave, or you go and you bull rush when they're already focused on the creeps, you catch them by surprise, and you go for the kills. So the fact that the response is not needed, or at least not as urgent, is what makes this difficult game. Now, immediate jump in the Doom Mountain to promise this shit. Mad Maniac will get brought down. And that was a ranged bash, by the way, off on the Stifling Dagger. Red will come through for an arguably late Ravage that gets stolen by the Rubick. He's got an Anchor Smash after these. It doesn't matter. Rawls is still alive only for a short time, though. 3 second stun. The disruption saves him. Oh, that could have been the killer there. Rawls will now go forward, but it's going to be a death on a Muku. Promises shit. That's going to be lassoed up or shackled to a creep. Rawls still alive. We'll go forward, but the Dagon will bring him down. It doesn't even matter as Muku or Promises shit has died. And that is 103 seconds on your Ursa. That was a dieback. Oh, boy. Only a 2 for 5. As it is, in the end, could be a team wipe. Now, for anyone that's still alive, it's a good thing that it is a Shadow Demon because he has a good amount of wave clear. So you just keep sending that Shadow Poison out, and this wave will not be able to survive. If you get caught too many times as a hero, you'll just get bursted down. But now they go in for the kill on the Shadow Demon, but it's not enough to bring him down. They've got a lot of slows onto him, but not enough killing potential. So Mad Maniac will make his way back into the fray, but what a fight to win if you're the Dire right now. Not only are the Radiant now struggling to continue this aggression, we talked about the majority of the reason why is because they're not able to control the pace of the game as much, but they've also lost 2 fights or so in a row. So looking at this one from an objective point of view, I would no longer say the Radiant are in a controlling point. In fact, the graph tells the entire story. They're now approaching equilibrium in that power, the power fight, the power vacuum, whatever you want to call it. They're about to hit that zero mark. And really, I mean, they're close, but the graphs dictate that, yeah, they might still be an advantage. Well, no. Momentum's half of Dota. So the fact that Dire now have the swing, have the momentum, have the curve going in their direction, that is where most, or if not all, the advantage is coming from right now. And sure, Radiant can still take fights, but they're fighting a team that's getting progressively stronger. And if they've lost the past 2 fights, well, then, I mean, trends should dictate that they will lose the next fight even harder. Now, what actually happens comes down to execution, but it's that kind of mindset that drives Dire to keep on pressing and keep finding more and more, getting a little bit more ambitious, and keeps the Radiant back and on their toes. So this next Roshan should go down. It looked like the Dire could probably contest it, but they weren't in the proper position for it. So the Radiant getting another Roshan, Aegis, and Cheese going to the same targets. Aegis will now go to Promises Shit, Cheese to Muku, and that gives a little bit more for the Radiant to work with. Last time they had an Aegis and Cheese fight, they were able to team wipe the Dire in their own base. So now, as history dictates, they should be able to do the same thing. 42 minutes in, though, 38-30. And I'm not quite sure the Dire are going to give them that advantage, but we'll have to see as the Siege will start in the mid lane, not really erupting to other lanes as they're both pushed in. So, or pushed out, I guess, would be the correct terminology for the situation at hand. But Promises Shit and Muku just going straight in. They Yules! Mad Maniac! He tries for the lasso, but gets immediately brought down. The Racks are in trouble, but the Ravage comes through. There's still an Aegis and a Cheese to be spent. Muku is holding on to it. Promises Shit will get brought down, but that is only the Aegis mortality. Muku's actually going to die. He ends up popping the Cheese, but he's getting ticked by the poison damage. He'll still survive, but the rest of the Dire Radiant team are dead. There's only 2 left. And Muku, he'll leave Promises Shit alone. Rawls still fighting. And even though he's low, he can just jump in, wait for the Furious Wipes to go down. He's got 7. Okay, he doesn't even need to wait. It's a team wipe. Aegis, Cheese, and 5 dead. Oh boy, that was essentially a 6 or 7 for 2. The gold swing will be about 38 to 3900 in favor of the Dire.
Radiant's
experience close
shape.
To 7,000 swung off that fight. And now the Dire. I mean, bull rush down the mid lane. You haven't won yet, Radiant but at best you can take a tier 2 shape. Tower easily. Mad Maniac is not going to be enough to defend. It looks like Rubick
one
will be back up as
Radiant.
Well, but you already got a top tier 2 tower. Get a bottom mid tier 2, maybe even a bottom tier 2, and you can consider that fight a true win. Now, there is going to be an Aegis or a Glyph to be spent, but it doesn't seem like the Radiant want to spend it for this one. Maybe they spend it for if the high ground push comes. No, they will spend the Glyph. And that, they get the deny off of it because of that, but Rawls pops BKB, will walk away. A denied tier 2 tower, probably on the menu, but I don't know, not quite the use of a glyph that you want. You lose one more fight, glyphs down for another 4.5 minutes. You lose a fight, you lose a Rax. If Davey Gravy is going to go out to the Glimmer Cape, will go down, but there's going to be a disruption on the Dota 2 customer service as Red is close by, no Ravage for 23. Dota 2 customer service, meanwhile, seems like he's going to get brought down as Rubick stealing Devour. Both Davey Gravy and Dota 2 customer service, though, have buybacks for the game. But I imagine if that fight had gone the other way, then Radiant would be losing Rax. Now that they've won the fight, I don't think they finish this Rax. Again, two buybacks available on the Dire for their two deaths, but in the end, I mean, a fight's a fight. Winning a fight's winning a fight, and whatever advantage they can take, I imagine they'll be happy with. Maybe they even will get this melee barracks. It's going to be tough, and I do think that Radiant are going to buy back, but I don't know. Maybe they just sack it. Looks like that's what they're going to do. They pop a glyph, but they're not going to buy back off the back of this one. So the Dire Radiant will go for two sets of racks, and the top tier 3 is rather healthy, but a Phantasm will get spent. There are six CK illusions here, whacking at this tower. They get two sets of racks for this. They refuse to buy back, and I don't know, but it just seems like that was not quite the play. The Yule Scepter will keep Mad Maniac from pulling in Red. And the Lasso does not connect in the Mad, but he will still die from this. But I mean, that's two sets of racks that are down. I don't know. I don't think that was worth it. I definitely think they should have spent buyback to preserve their racks, but 46 minutes in. I mean, the game is approaching that point where you would count a team out. But I guess I'll take that back. If this was 30 minutes into the game, 35 minutes, I think would be the latest. Two racks would be a death sentence. You'd say, oh yeah, the Dire are probably out of this one. But because it's 46 minutes of the game, because you've got a Battle Fury onto Rawls and ample wave clear from both Rawls and Yoda, I mean, if Yoda buys a Mjolnir, or, I mean, it looks like he's going for the Daedalus, but he'll be able to clean up waves pretty quickly on his own too. So the general gist of the game here is that, yeah, the Dire aren't in too bad of a spot. Sure, they're going to have to constantly worry about two of their racks, but not being able to control the pace does not stop a Phantom Assassin. What they do is they defend when they have to, and they find picks when they can. So go back, push out the mid, push out the top. When they're at about the river, or I guess the river would be right here, the river or a little bit past, then you immediately group up, smoke, and find a pick. You find a pick, then you go to one of those lanes that are pushed out at least a little bit, or maybe the bottom lane is pushed in, and you take down a Rax or two. Like, it doesn't even matter if the creeps are pushing into your base. You've got tier 4s to defend. You go in and you find kills elsewhere. Speaking of, the customer service will get picked. Once again, though, the Rubick will steal Devour, but these picks are proving to be the end game for the Dire, and now maybe not looking as good for them. Okay, it wasn't looking great initially, but I did say that they had a good shot. Now they have to buy back the Doom. Like, they can't just stubbornly say, no, we do not want to buy back him anymore. That ship has sailed. In fact, that ship got burnt to the ground in the last fight. But I guess some good can come out of it, because if he had died there and he had bought back in the last fight, he'd be down for sure. But I'll stick to my guns and say this wouldn't be happening if he had bought back and defended in the last fight. Whatever the case, getting picked off is not good. So another Phantasm. Looks like, did he pop? Yeah, he did pop Phantasm. And Manta style, lot of illusions. They do have to buy back the Doomguild, TP him in. Red is still alive to this one. He'll pop the Ravage. These illusions getting cleaned up, but once again, they'll steal Ravage. They have to stop letting this happen. Rawls will come forward. He pops the, doesn't even pop the Satanic. He's just regening through everything. Promises shit now. Heaven's Albert out onto him will stop him from attacking, but that doesn't stop him from bringing down Red. Rawls goes aggressive in. He's got the Demonic Purge, and it looks like that'll be enough to bring him down, but he's got the buyback. Doesn't even need to spend it. I imagine, yeah, just a push and the game, but it's a 2-for-3. And now they want to bring down Shadow Demon, but can they continue going further? Blink Dagger in 3 seconds, 2-1. He'll go for the TP. Can they get it? They will! Where'd the vision come from? Okay, so Davy Gravy, he'll go down to the Dagon, the Ethereal Blade Dagon 5. And the Naganim Scepter will be completed. But that means he doesn't have buyback. Alright. Still, it seems the Dire are overly stubborn at spending their buybacks. To be perfectly honest, if I were in this scenario, I probably would have bought back and just barrel rushed down the mid lane to get some racks. I mean, you've got a tier 2 bottom, but you do not have one top, so you could easily take a mid and top racks and equalize that advantage, but I don't know. I'm not them. I don't make decisions for them, and ultimately, they probably wouldn't have gotten there in time, so it may have been a bad decision on my call anyway. Double damage. Hey, make the right decisions, win games, right? Dota 2 customer service, once again, same story, different time. He's going to get lassoed up, or no, he'll find a blink away. But, okay. Yeah, now it's the same story, different time. Dota 2 customer service getting picked off once again, or at least he's facing a pickoff. I'm not sure this they'll actually get this one, as they're trying to run in with Muku. In fact, maybe they counter-initiate onto this. No, Radiant will get smart and back away. They want no part in this one. That could have been a pretty major kill, but the problem with Batrider is that if you've got no one close by, you don't exactly have solo kill potential. Unless you're really far ahead and the Doom is really far behind. But meanwhile, the Radar of the Dire. Oh, actually, Rubik! Okay, that shouldn't have happened. First, many things went wrong there, but the primary thing is that you don't blink up onto the high ground with no vision. That's the big thing. Now Red will turn around on a Mad Maniac. If Rubik buys back, he cannot get into this fight. So, promises shit, will turn around, go out, end a Rawls. Remember, there is an MKB, so Rawls has to be very careful about this one. Mad Maniac has gone down. They'll turn around to promises shit, but Muku comes forward. They will last him up to a tree. Now the Doom out. Muku, he's got no way to survive this one. He'll get brought down. Promises shit, meanwhile, just getting kited. He's brought down as well. It is getting close to a team fight. As Shadow Demon, the only one left alive. They've got to be careful at who jumps in, though, because remember, he's got the Demonic Purge, he's got the Ethereal Blade. Dagon isn't even able to get it out. Oh boy, it's a five-man wipe, only one with buyback. This is it. Red has gone back to defend because he's the only one really needed. But they have no creeps. Where are your creeps? Oh man, this is unfortunate. Maybe they can go through buyback. They just going through buyback protection. Oh boy, they'll pop a glyph, but this is hilarious. Even with a Fade Bolt, they've got enough damage for it. And Yoda will have the Focus Fire back up again. They get racks through buyback protection. The creeps will come through very soon, so they should be able to get two sets of racks here. They're just leaving the melee out of the ranged barracks. They want the other tower, and buyback protection goes down right about now. As that is gone, they'll bring down the second set of racks. They can go right back to the first. And Dota 2 customer service has nailed it. Hit the nail on the head. And yeah, I fucked up. Mad Maniac, I agree, dude. At 50 minutes in the game, you have to have buyback. Buying out the Aghanim Scepter, was it worth it? Absolutely not, in my opinion. But in hindsight, yeah. It's always 2020. In the moment, it might have seemed like a great idea, but I'm lucky. I can look at a play and be like, yeah, that was definitely a bad idea. But I probably would have been the one making the play in game. I'm not going to lie. So Batrider will push himself forward. Going on, farming up the jungle. Muku, meanwhile, he's popped into his illusion, split up, going for the top. Rawls will turn around and fight. Muku, he's alone. Okay, now he's got some support coming in, but it's going to be on the side of Mad Maniac. Yeah, he's got no way to survive this one. Dagon will come up, but it's not going to do enough damage to customer service to really make a difference. And look at the damage. Promises shit goes down the level. Death proving to be way too much. Shadow Demon will pop himself into the ethereal form, but yeah, he's down. Still no buybacks. And would you look at that? Bottom lane pushing in. Do they even go for the Roshan? Do they even go for the... Yeah, okay, go for the bottom lane, guys. You're mid to push down. Just bring down this tier 2 tower. Okay, looks like they just want to end the game. I don't blame them. I really don't. 54 and a half minutes. 46 to 49. I guess I was going to say kills don't matter. Only Ancient matters, but they've got the kills, so I guess kills do matter. Dota 2 customer service, you've already won. Don't rub salt in the wound, dude. As it looks like, yeah, they've got plenty of tower damage. It's going to be a full-on Phantasm, but yeah, the illusions are going to drop just as soon. Another Ravage! What is that, the fourth one stolen by Rubick? Okay, this guy doesn't deserve to lose. I'm going to be perfectly honest. Red, yeah, he should have been a little bit more on top of keeping those Ravages from being stolen. It isn't hard to immediately Anchor Smash or shift through the Anchor Smash just to keep it from getting stolen, but sometimes, I don't know. 55 minutes and 16 seconds is the final game time. Oh boy. And the all chat flame coming out from Dota 2 customer service. I wish I saw what this guy was like in team chat, especially when they were going down. You don't need to all chat flame Red, dude. I think he knows. Whatever the case, guys, thank you for watching. Thank you very much to Rawls, who was the one who sent in this replay. I greatly appreciate it, man. Look forward to any in the future coming out from you. Regardless of the case, if you're watching and you've got your own replay to cast, or that you want casted. Wow, I am fucking up this outro. If you have your own replay that you want cast, you can go ahead and shoot me an email. The email is in the description of this video. For more, it is, of course, by a fee. $10 per request, either live or recorded. Just shoot me your information. We'll talk about it. Get it set up from there, guys. Of course, if you like the video itself, you can like, favorite, subscribe, that whole ordeal. Because this is going to be on YouTube, of course. Thank you very much for watching, guys. And I will catch you all for the next replay.